Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Peacemaker 2448 here, back once more with Fire Emblem, Path of Radiance. Last time, we united with the Galleon army, and now we are twice as strong as we are. Unfortunately, Ashnard has a whole bunch of shit where has the medallion. Lene kind of has us in check because we kind of risk releasing the Dark God in the medallion if we go after him, but we have to go after him in order to get Crimea back, and to get Lene back, and to get the medallion back if the Dark God's not released. Oh, and yeah. So, we're kind of up shit creek without a paddle. Again. This time, as I said at the end of the last episode, we are starting the largest battle in Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. So let's get rolling. Any value amidst the manhunting. Damn it! I can't even say words correctly again. Marhoot Range. Ike and company are united with King Kynus of Gallia. King Tiberon of Phoenicius also arrives and brings with him a disturbing tale. His words serve notice. There is no time to waste. The final showdown with Ashnard is coming. Between the forces King Kynus grants them before returning home, and the soldiers King Tiberon brings, the Crimean army possesses three times the fighting power that it did when it left Benyon. Even so, the Dayan forces encamped in the capital are strong, rested, and comparable in numbers. In addition, the road to the final confrontation is blocked by two formidable obstacles. Fort Pinell and Ados Castle. How these two tests are faced will mightily affect the course of the war. Meanwhile, at the bad guys. I see. So Crimean and Gallia have finally joined forces, have they? Half-breeds and humans fighting side by side. How sweet. In addition, it seems the incident with the Heron Princess has brought more Phoenicians to the struggle as well. Ooh, the Hawk King is getting involved, eh? Which means that the Crimean army's strength of arms is all but equal to our own. And growing daily. Of course, this is pathetic. Ragged band is still no match for our superior leadership and skill. Things are getting interesting, are they not? But I am still unsatisfied. Divided our army into two, battles, and send one to meet the Crimeans. And who will be in charge of that battalion? Bertram. Does that bother you? Well then, perhaps I should leave it to you and see what happens. Do you believe I would betray you? I believe your heart has considered it. Surely you jest. I will divide our forces and see that they march to Crimea under Bertram. Command. Is this satisfactory? I leave it to you, good sir knight. One other thing, your majesty. In my absence, did you order the death of Aina?
Aina. Oh yes, her! I forgot about that one. I lost all interest in her when she failed to hold Dayan's capital. You know, I have no use for failures. Yes, I remember it now. I ordered General Petrine to take care of her. Another failure under my command. I told Petrine that if the task was beyond her, capturing Aina would be enough.
I see.
Why do you ask?
According to one of General Petrine's men, they have indeed captured Aina. But with General's death, they aren't sure what to do with her.
Ah, that was one of Patrine's better qualities. She always did follow orders. Well, what do you intend to do?
I wish to receive your instructions. Do you still wish to see her killed? Or have you changed your mind?
Do as you will, I care not. However, do not bring her into my presence. When that one is near, Rajan seems to grow restless.
As you wish.
Everyone seems to be here. Go ahead, Soren. You can begin now. Very well. Please look at this map. The current position of our army is here, at the Mardhut Range. Between us and the capital there are two large outposts of enemy troops, Fort Pinell and Erdos Castle. Both holds were built to guard our land. Not guardian, I believe that's translation error. But now Dayan rules them both, and those of us. With the rations set, they could hold out a year. Say what you will of Dayan and her foul plans, one must admire her skill in things of war. Come now, Bastion. What would you praise our foe? Crap, I forgot to read who was the fuck reading that. I still thought it was Soren. Oops. I do but speak the mean of it, good sir. The truth is harsh, but lies would be worse still. Will you two please shut up? Please. I thought that was still Soren talking. Crap. This is what happens when I don't have portraits. I default to who I think is talking. Patel and Nados are fairly close to one another. I doubt they would expect us to attack both at once, but there seems to be a waste of our strength, and we don't want to get ambushed from the rear while attacking. We cannot divide our army, but we could send a small force to attack the base while with weaker defenses and keep it occupied. At the same time, the main army can focus on the other one and conquer it. I see. So which one has more soldiers? That would be Fort Pinell. Very well. Then the main army will lead an assault on Fort Pinell. Meanwhile, I'll take my army and a unit or so of galleons and set out for Castle Nidus. We'll launch an attack, and when they come out to meet us, we'll retreat. Then we'll attack again. It will keep them busy. That should give us time. We need. We'll take care of our front by day's end. Let's go capture a fort. Let's settle then. Completely missed my opportunity to sing some more with Bastion. Alright, folks. Took care of a crap ton of reorganizing items and stuff on the back end to make sure my units are equipped for this battle, because, oh boy, do we gotta be equipped for this battle. Anywho. Like I said, this is gonna be the largest battle, so as a note ahead, if you're playing along with the video, which I don't know why you'd be playing along with the video and just playing along the chapter after you've watched the video, before you watch the video, or whatever. Anyway, you're going to need 19 units for this chapter. Yes, 19 units. That is a lot, in more than just about every, and quite a bit more than every other chapter you've had so far. So, keep that in mind when you're going into this chapter. So, the 19 units you're going to want to bring in are pretty much your best and strongest units, along with anyone you need to level up, like Ike and Mist, although Ike is required to begin with. So, like Mist. Now, you are going to get a unit off the bat that I believe is required for this chapter, so you're going to be pretty much down to 17 units you're going to actually choose. Ike plus one more.
So, again, keep that in mind.
Alright, so we shall get this chapter underway with that note in mind. I didn't really do anything else important, any skill distribution, because I have no other skills really to distribute. Just distributing some bonus experience to a bunch of units, just get them topped off on their levels that they were at in the previous chapter, or get them up a level, and also outfitting them so they have all the best weapons they could equip at the moment. So, anyway, let's get rolling.
My Lord Ike. Princess Silencia. When did you change your sprite?
What's going on? Why are you dressed like that?
I thought to join you on the battlefield, on the battle lines.
Is that a Pegasus?
When'd you get Pegasus? He belonged to my great-grandmother. I'm a bit nervous about riding him, but I'm going to try nonetheless.
I appreciate your desire, but your retainers will never allow it, will they?
As for that...
Oh, no. Did you agree to this, Joffrey?
No. Personally, I'm against it, but she is the princess, and it is her wish.
I can do nothing.
The princess's great-grandmother was a Binyon Pegasus Knight of some renown before marrying into House Crimea. Princess Alencia herself is skilled at both riding and swordsmanship. As a child, she was granted permission to train in case the need for her to fight ever arose.
Behold the Pegasus in uniform, all treasures of our House Crimea fair. We did fear much that we would never see a chance to use them in their proper stead. Oh, Muse of Fire, I cannot find the words. Behold the light that dares to shame the sun. Our princess, clad in raiments fair and fine, gives courage, love, and vigor to our cause.
Bastion, shut up.
I can't help it. I like to sing.
I'm surprised you were able to hide armor in a flying horse from the Dayan army.
Ahem. Prince Redding foresaw a time when the princess would need them, and bade us convey them from the palace. Prince Redding's thoughts were always of the princess, even as his life abandoned him. Be true to your heart, and live life as it dictates. Those were his final words to her.
My lord uncle was always the one person who understood me best. Even though I'm dressed like this, I have no experience, and do not expect to fight as well as the rest of you. But this constant waiting behind and doing nothing, it sets my heart beating with such unease, I fear it may burst. Even if I cannot fight, I could use a staff to heal the wounded. If I could save just one soldier, it means so much to me. Please, my Lord Ike, I promise to obey orders and stay out of harm's way as best I can.
Lord Ike, will you take responsibility and guard the princess?
It is her heartfelt wish.
This is not something I can allow or disallow. She's my employer. This is what the princess wants. All I can do is comply, because goddamn ethics.
Be careful, will you? This is sounding like a dumb idea already. Oh, thank you so much.
Let us go forth like sunlight to the dawn. Alencia fights, and Crimea wins the day.
God damn it. We'll get to her in a bit. Don't worry, folks.
Ike, there are more enemy soldiers than we expected. Just from what I can see now, they are double our numbers.
And we must assume that the fort houses many more troops.
This may prove to be a long battle.
Even if we have 20 times our numbers, we must overcome them.
In this war, there can be no retreat.
So yeah, just to give you an idea, folks, of what we're dealing with here. On our side, 19. On their side, 30 fucking 5. But all we have to do is seize the one point over here, where Bertram is. I mean, that's simple enough, right? Except he has a rune sword that deals magic damage. And it restores HP. Half the HP it does in damage. This is not going to go well, is it? So yes, you are in for a long, long fight. And you have a lot of units to deal with. Good news is, you bring 19 along. Also, just like I said before, Alencia is required. Speaking of Alencia, the princess finally joins us! Almost at the end of the game! At level 1! In her, I guess, promoted class! Because she's technically a Pegasus Knight. Okay, to be flat honest with you, she's not that good. In terms of the two main characters that have unique classes, because we're not counting Largo in this conversation here. Ike and Alencia. Ike is really good. Alencia, not so much. She has an unbreakable form in the form of a Miti, which essentially gives her a innate double hit, double strike. And she can also use healing staffs. Plus, she's like, unfortunately, she's a D rank on swords, meaning you can't give her a good sword, another sword besides a Matri that would be good for her, but she can equip any staff, pretty much. But yeah, the Unbreakable Sword is on the very breakable unit, because she has very low defense. I mean, we're talking about a, what, 11 defense, plus 3, so that puts her at 14, which puts her right in line with... There she is. Rolf? So, yeah. And her resistance is 15, 16, 17, 18? Which I think is actually pretty good, considering all things. Let me check real quick. I'll give a comparison here real quick. Yeah, that puts her, like, on par with a lot of our other mages. The back end of our mages, really, with, like, Khalil and Bastion. But that's still pretty good, considering all things, for level 1. So, if you got a great deal of bonus experience sitting around, you can dump it into her and get her better. But what she's really good for is you have a flying healing unit now. And just like Mist, she can get around a lot and heal. Plus, she can back up after she goes to heals. It's almost like she's really meant to be a healer unit than an offensive unit. Because if you want a good Alencia unit, go play Fire Emblem Radiant Dawn, where she's actually good because she starts, because you get her at the beginning of the fucking game! And have a chance to level her up properly and not go, oh, she's level 1 when I don't really have time to deal with level 1 units. Anyway. Like I said, you're bringing in 17 units plus Ike and Alencia, and I've already picked out these 17 units. Not you. You. Not you. You. Not you, you. And I do believe that's it. Let me check real quick. Let me get use just as real quick. Don't mind me, I'm double-checking because I listed out, wrote down, like, who I'm bringing into this fight just to keep track, because it's up to fucking 19 units. It's a lot of units to bring into this fight. Alright.
So, yeah, 19 units in Alencia is not that good. So, but it gives us a fourth different fucking healer we can use who's good at healing. So, anyway, I'm gonna put almost all my mounted units up front. At least all the flying ones besides Alencia. I'll put Oscar up front. Right now, I'll leave Tanya up front with Oscar over here. Get everyone. In position. I'll put Broke up front, because fuck it, why not? Not racing can be in the fucking back. If I can pick that square, thank you. Jesus. Would not let me pick that square. There we go. Okay. So yeah, this is a big battle. And to think, this isn't the one I'm worried about. The one I'm worried about is next chapter. After the rest of that chapter. So, let's get this started and see what madness awaits us.
General Bertram! Crimean army has risen to the bait! Order, sir?
Your order, sir?
General? How shall we make answer?
Turn the ground soft with blood. Make a graveyard of this place. Bury them all.
Yes, sir!
Soren, do you have any information on the enemy, General? Our intelligence reports say the commander of this army is Bertram, one of Dane's four riders.
One of the four riders? So he's on par with the woman we fought earlier, General Katrine. Even though we whooped the monkey ass of her and didn't have to worry about her.
That's not necessarily so. The name Four Riders is given to the four persons of highest ability among the king's advisors. So, the members can change, is that it? Change, is that it? Who are the current Four Riders?
First, there was General Katrine, whom we defeated at Riven Bridge. Then the man we face today, General Bertram. Next is General Bryce, who served in the previous game. And finally, the enigmatic general known as the Black Knight. Those are the four.
This is the same Black Knight who murdered Commander Grail.
Of that, there appears to be no little doubt.
Tell us, Soren, do you have any more information on General Bertram?
I know not what he hails from. He appears after the fall of Crimea and has quickly gained Ashnard's favor.
So he's a man of known mean ability.
Like the Black Knight, he always wears his armor and never shows his face in the helmet. Some say he's not even in his armor, but that it's inhabited by an ancient specter or a demonic creature. It's all just superstition, rumor designed to heighten fear of the men.
It's not important. With your cross swords, we'll know the truth. Then we can discover for ourselves if he's just a loudmouthed braggart or truly a monster. As long as our blades can wound him, I care not either way. Let's go!
Alright, folks. Here on a second attempt at this, because I kind of fucked up the last one. By fucked up, I mean I kind of had a random crit happen that cost me this map. Even though it was fairly close to the end, I believe. Alright. So, I found success doing what I did before, so I'm kinda do what I did before, even though you're not going to see it. Which is to kinda set up a pseudo-esque barrier. Kind of catch these
first few units. We're gonna see what we can do to pull them in. So yeah, we get 19 units, so it's gonna be a lot of just moving shit back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Nearly everyone. Alright. Now we wait and see how long this enemy phase turn takes. Alright, you have 6 pack mana. Forget about that. There. See, even though I'm second attempt, I'm still fucking forget shit. Alright, you're down to 8 health. Fantastic. So I have to worry about you, the better. So these guys are just pretty much move in, do their stuff. Like they took a decent hit right there, jeez. So yeah, this is a second attempt at this. Random swordsman managed to get a crit on Stefan. It just happened out of nowhere. There was nothing I could really do to stop it. So beyond Jesus, be unhappy with me right now. Looks like Tanya and Oscar pulled the majority of the guys to the right, which is fine. Mostly just trying to get as many units initiated, which might be, might sound bad, but at least moving in a direction. That way I can kind of just constantly take them down one after another, so I don't have to worry about them. There's two bow knights there. Or two bowmen. Yeah, that one. Which Titania should be able to take care of. There's silver axe. Hi, pointless crit. Titania had that without the crit. Just saying. Void mood of up. Attacking one of these mounted units. Nice hit, Void. As long as you get this. There goes a counter rocking right there. Nice. We got a silver sword out of it. Also, we're just gonna go take care of our other archer friend here. So yeah, kind of playing this by numbers at the moment, not doing anything real fancy, so. Because I just need to find something to talk about, unless that decides to curse me. Because I think every time I try to talk about something besides the game, I end up, like, cursing the game. I end up getting cursed, and, end up having issues. So I don't know, but screw it. Recording this the Monday after I attempted to record the other episodes. The last couple episodes I've been trying to record. Well, last one and like the rest of this chapter, so. Yeah, it's a separate recording session. Breaking some Let's Play rule here somewhere, I think. I don't know. I don't know. I wouldn't think so. Anyway, so D23 is kind of wrapped up. We kind of got the Disney actor panel yesterday, and I didn't hear anything like really new out of Battlefront besides, hey, we got a fancy PlayStation, Darth Vader PlayStation 4 you can pick up with some exclusive content. Ooh, fancy. Some Death Rock, nice. Disney Infinity announced a whole bunch of stuff, which I don't give a shit about. Funny, weird thing is, and the thing that, like, just about pissed me off, was they announced Peter Pan, which, normally I have no problem with that. Hell, I encouraged, like, them to dig into the classic Disney roster in order to put them out as Disney, as Infinity characters. Problem is, Pan was on the fan vote, and there was some misreporting, I think, going around that Pan was announced as the winner of the fan vote, which was horseshit. If you've kept up with the fan vote like I have, you know that's full of shit. Peter Pan got nowhere near the numbers he needed to actually win. To be considered winner of the fan vote. But apparently what ended up happening is it was the artist choice. Essentially their fan creators, I think. They picked Pan. I think the problem was Pan was also on the fan vote, so people assumed that he was the fan vote winner off the bat without double checking things. And he'll let they first. Oh, hi, Killing Edge. I see you there. So, yeah. I guess the fan vote still hasn't been decided yet. Honestly, I hope it does happen to be one of the two people that are, you know, from the looks of it, going to be the people who win the fan vote. It's either Darkwing Duck or Maple at this point, considering they're the only options you can choose on the fan vote that's still active, by the way. It hasn't gone down at all. Right, you don't... Crap, I forgot to give Tanith an actual ranged weapon. She needs a ranged weapon. As long as she doesn't miss, we should be fine. There we go. Like, it's either one of those two, because they're the only choices active at this point. I think Maple is going to end up winning. Sad, because I would totally like for Darkwing Duck to win. But I'm completely fine with Maple. Like, I have no issues with that. I'm gonna kind of split up some units here. I'm gonna get Ryze to fire off a purge shot. So yeah, Kingdom Hearts thing was cool. Even though it wasn't, like, it wasn't as much as one would hope for, since it was just, hey, we're doing a big, there's going to be a big Hero 6 world, and it's going to be after the movie, and they shot off this cool piece of concept art for said world, and that was the short and long of the conversation. Outside of, hey, the Ultimate Unlock is the Kingdom Key for Disney Infinity 3.0, so if you buy all the characters, you get the Kingdom Key to use, and for those in attendance, you got essentially a costume change for the Mickey Infinity character. So now he can look like King Mickey from Kingdom Hearts. Again, that it's like wasn't like the most groundbreaking thing to hear about Kingdom Hearts, especially groundbreaking thing about Kingdom Hearts, but apparently I think there's another D23 in November, maybe? I'm just reading the wrong information. That we'll get some better, more Kingdom Hearts 3 information. And honestly, we're gonna get information about Kingdom Hearts 3 spread throughout the next couple years. So I'm content to wait. I've been waiting this long for 3, so I'm just content to wait. We'll get all the information we could want or need. Just have to be patient about it. hell, I'm sure they're, like, holding out on a really good trailer for the next, in the next, like, few months. That'd be really cool to see. So yeah, just moving along at the speed of blurg at the moment. Because we're just kind of taking out these next few units. They're kind of coming off the waves. Yeah, we got a ton of units to deal with, so I'm just kind of taking them one unit at a time, kind of. It's one of the goose weaponry that we're going to be needing in a couple chapters. Now, I believe I said this in previous recording. I don't know if I've said it yet. I might be, might not have. But, I might be repeating myself here. But this chapter isn't a big worry. I mean, you have 19 units available to you. That is a ton of units to have at your disposal and a variety of weapons at your disposal. There shouldn't be any too big concern about needing anyone, really. Because you should have everyone you could want or need in this chapter. Now, the chapter that worries me is next chapter, mainly because of the additional fight you have to do. Because, spoilers, there's an additional fight on top of doing an entire chapter next time. That's what worries me, because there's an outcome I want in that chapter, and I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get it. That physics staff. So, next chapter is what worries me. This chapter, not so much. It's mainly just, hey, you've got a ton of units on your side. They got, like, three times as more units on their side. Good luck, have fun. See if I can get him. Damn, down to 2 health. I'll at least keep him running again. I'm gonna have some units start moving this way. Mostly did that for the experience, that's more than anything else right there. Nice job to Tanya, able to reach our long-range mage right here. So yeah. Kingdom Hearts news was cool from D23, but not much else. Did check out the TSM Team Liquid match, went 3-1. I find it odd that I'm not as interested as I could be in terms of, like, league, professional league stuff in like, a full game as much as it is in just, like, watching a game happen. Or watching highlights of it. It might be because, like, league matches, league games are, like, an hour long, and they do have, well, at least in North America, they have a lot of downtime right at the beginning. Because it's just a lot of setup and getting ready for mid to late game, so. Might just be me not being as in tune or in touch with, like, the professional scene. Maybe I'm not seeing all the little things that are happening per chapter or per minute in a league, so. Yeah. By the way, TSM won, like, again, 3-1. They're going on the face. Was it CLG? And yeah, CLG in the finals next weekend. Might be interesting to see. Gotta start knocking these guys down. Got some feral lagoons we gotta take care of. pounce, steady pounce, steady pounce, pounce, pounce. Remember, I take care of the... not the Brave Boar. Brave Sword, the Silver Sword. Take care of the big guy. Nice. When I gonna have some more experience, hopefully. Little fire! I think that takes care of all our immediate threats for this big group of units that we have at our disposal. Or big group of units in this area. Let's say at our disposal. In this area. Let's see if I can draw some out right there. Somebody right there. Keep attacking that same swordsman. Finally got him. That blows the rest of my purge. Almost leveled up Raz right there. Damn. And he was the only one in range. Wow. Train up Ike, get him moved up. Maybe he can draw the rest of them in. That or get like a ton of kills. One or the other. Let's see, moving in. I should have healed with her. Oh well. Not that big of a deal. I'll just heal with her next time. And we got three units to deal with. Oscar, go Iron Bow. And that barrel one's down. So yeah, rolling along. That's a decent, that's a pretty good level up, I would say. Range, just so I'm aware. Any potential to choose to come. Let me back chill up to. Actually, no. Send short spears. Only got one hit, and I want the double hit. Let's see if Jill can take this guy out. She might. Nope, not enough damage. Right down to 3 health. That never. Actually, I think those two got it, so I'm gonna let. Missed. Heal up Boyd, and Boyd's gonna head off to join the rest of the army. Actually, I'll have both of them do that, because. Between Oscar and Titania, they should be good. So Oscar, Titania, and Jill, they should be fine. A little bit damage, not much. They're pretty weak, so. For the three of them, they should be able to take these two guys out. Yeah, of course. Our bowman goes after Ike. Anyone else gonna go after him, or is it just gonna be the bowman? Wow, he fucking both run, Jesus. We got more right there. Racing with the Jason Square heal. And transforms. Window primarily those guys. What's my range? of Ike dive deep. One shot our priest friend here. So if Ike dives deep, they might go after him, and I could use the levels, to be flat honest. Skill up, that's what I'm looking for, is the skill ups. Go with the Flame Lance, just in case any range units come after Nufini. And that doesn't kill him. Fucking fantastic. Of course it doesn't. I go with the safer option, and that doesn't get me the kill. So I guess I will... I can't risk. Any people right there? I'll have Boyd, like, take a step there. See if that pulls some few people. Let's see what the heal. Just kind of stay put. Yeah, I'll go with Mag for the archer kill. Wow, and a death proc, that's not going to get me anything because she already had it. Okay. Oscar, fire away once more. Nicely done. Probably have Joe pick up that last Wyvern kill. Since Tanya is the farthest away and she probably needs all her movement to catch back up. Somebody meet up with her to heal her up. She's pretty low. Here comes everybody else. Let's see what the damage is. Am I a good tactician or a bad tactician? To be honest, at this point, someone should be able to judge me fairly on that. I'm probably a terrible one. I'm surprised no one's going after Ike. Well, I know why people would go after Boy. He's got Provoke, which would, like, pull him in his direction. But I'm surprised no one's going after Ike, considering how deep he is in terms of their territory. I wonder if that figures into their AI, how deep someone is into the range of units. There goes one of them. Eight for the heal! Fantastic. Almost feel like fully. That's a nicely done one. Ow. Brave sword. Pretty much taking off that heal. Great that I did get healed right there. Otherwise I might have been either dead or in trouble. Actually, he might have died right there if he didn't get the proc. Look at me playing dangerously. And one more going after Oscar. Or not Oscar, Boyd. Short spear. I think the paladins would come out. I fear they would stick near there. Dodge. Has to get those dodges. Nice job, Ike. Couple more pulling out. But they's not helping me anymore. Let me get these three moved in. That way I know unit-wise where my best options. I think that puts her out of range of anyone. Yeah, it puts her out of range of anyone. Might have Jill try to flank around, maybe take out some of these units on the side, since she's in position to do that. Anyone weak in this range? Not really. Fantastic. Size those guys at the moment. I'll focus that archer guy first. Renolf should get him. Nice job, Renolf. That's one less you have to worry about. Should still be fine. That should get the kill as long as it hits. It did. Nice. Nicely done, Boyd. Shine away on our Wyvern Rider here. She's taking on out. Yes, nicely done. I think I'm good at the moment. We're doing really good right now. No one's really taking any big heavy damage besides Ike right there, but Aether protected him. Nafini. Skill 23. I go for the kill on this guy. Dodge. Nicely done. So far, so good. Still got, what, 8 units left? That's our big bad boss. Or 7 units, so yeah, that's our big bad boss, so. Fuck it. I've been doing good so far, might as well risk it for the biscuit. This might be able to get the kill here. Did that die? Nice! Nice job, missed. Whew. I was really scared there for a second, because I didn't think she would actually get the kill. It might have died. Good. I'll play it safe with Stefan, because last time he was the reason I died, so... The reason I had to redo this map, so I'm gonna play it safe with him. No, I'm gonna have you heal Ike, because that's the safer thing for you, because I don't trust you going up against him, because he's full health. You're not gonna get the kill, and you help Ike even die. I'm gonna need a Brave Sword to guarantee the kill. And it's not necessary, because Ike crits on the first shot. Alright, fine, whatever. Jesus. Chain up Ike and Ophini and move them forward. Alright. Those guys are coming in. One goes after Ike. Brave Short can keep him safe. And Aether on the first shot, because... Of course it is. Jesus, Ike, calm down. Calm down on these first shots. Another level up for you. Yeah, I don't need your magic. I need everything but your magic, really. And what goes after Renolf? Short axe. Dodge. You suck. Ah, fantastic. Three fucking mages as well. And they all have fucking long range magic. Fan fucking tastic. And one of them puts somebody in direct range. Fuck. That complicates matters. That heavily complicates matters, because that means I have to rethink strategies now. Until they're taken care of, I can't really send several units in. Stupid fucking long-range mages. Prevent my advancement. I'm pretty much gonna have to drop Renault back, because he can't take a fire shot. A fire magic shot. Because he's weak to that shit, so... Gosh, shine, but I need you down. Renolf needs to back up. This needs to back up. Back Stefan up, just because... Back up Renolf. Back up Soren, just to be safe. I'll back up several units, just to be safe. Damage, because resistance will probably knock out. Yeah, it's gonna knock out a lot of the hell. A lot of the damage Lifini would have had. She gave her a range lance that wasn't devoted by magic. move you out. Move you out. And super move you out. Ah, you're gonna attack with... You're not long range magic. Oh, that wasn't too bad. All that bluster, and that wasn't too bad of a hit for Wood Take. He's gonna take some more long range hits. He's fine. Maybe he's gonna have to deal with our armored knight here. Lugu's Lance, meaning it's not any bonus damage on Feeny. Whew. What the hell are you doing? Trying to poison or put Boyd to sleep? Atra's take more against the rune sword. Cause I know that puts him in range. The rune sword is, yeah, it's range 1-2. I know that puts him in range, but I've got new options. I gotta get these range, yeah, these long range magic guys down. That way I can attempt to bring in the rest of my units. Oh, you are asleep for 4 turns. Fuck! You son of a bitch. Fuck you. My PB is so kind. Take care of him. Nice adept proc, even though it wasn't necessary. We're doing good, we're doing good. We're still good. Still good so far. But this, all there's left is Bertram with his rune sword and his spear. Should be in range for the heal. Some boy's gonna be useless to me for the rest of this fight. No, he's got a Lugu's Lance. Never mind. But forget about the Lugu's Lance. Give that to Tanya. Moment of truth here, folks. Always an attack with a spear. Perish. Perish! So you're Bertram, are you? Sorry, but I can't perish right now. Me. Kill. What? Kill me. Kill me! What's going on? Are you mad? Nice job, dodge, Ike. And of course you go after Ike. Fan, it's good enough. It's fine by me. Give Ike a little bit more experience. Ooh, double hit and Aether Strike. Back up my units here real quick. I want all units in range to do something before I go after Bertram. Let they near void, since they're all going to be useless to me at the moment. That looks like I get the kill. Just going to stay there. Move up. If I can get the kill with miss, that'd be one thing, but I doubt that's happening. Alright. Come on. Move in. Ah, fan. Really? Three more fucking units to deal with? Oh my god. Fucking hell. I would love to give Ike the kill, but he needs the capture and seize the point, and I'm not risking it, so. Fucking terrific. At least longbow you. Pettish! Of course it does no damage, I should check. This is one experience point for Rolf, goddammit. Okay. He's got the spear right now, so an axe wielder would be fantastic. Which would be hard. Not that good. That wasn't that much damage, but a dodge and a hit, something. Go try to take care of some of these guys. At least a couple, one of them. They have plenty of units they can rescue and swap somebody out. Magic up and down even though she doesn't fucking need it. So far, go. You're better serve me over there. Nice crit! Which only leaves you. Oh, you got a little gizmo. Fantastic. I mean, that would outright hit you with miss and not have to worry about a damn thing. And miss got the kill. Fantastic. That. Alright. That means I don't have to worry about any last reinforcements. Or any reinforcements whacking me from the side. At least for the moment. Alright. Hard, would you mind letting me get out so I can get somebody else in there? Thank you. Let's see what you can do. 1 point crit. Damn. It's a hit. And a dodge.
And nice adept proc into a crit! Yeah! Release.
Nice. Nice job, Mai. That adept proc allowed that crit to happen. Yeah. Yeah. I'm so glad I put adept on you then. And you're level 15. With one single HP up. The fucking course. And we got a rune sword in the process. Yeah. There's nothing else for me to do. So, Ike. Season clear.
Sir, the enemy troops are fleeing. Shall we give chase?
No, let them run. We fought enough today. Get our men inside the fort and give everyone a break.
Yes, sir.
Meanwhile, at Crimea Castle. Mm-hmm.
I see. So Crimea's won another victory, have they?
Well then, send the rest of our troops to Castle Manus as reinforcements.
Put General Halfhead in charge, and let him exchange blows with them.
Yet that would leave the capital protected by only the Imperial Guard.
You forget yourself, knight. I will be here as well. If they defeat Halfhead and make it all the way here, then they are worthy to cross swords with me.
I would beg a question, Your Highness. Why do you divide our troops and give the enemy the advantage?
As if I were what? Go on.
It's as if you desire the Crimean army to continue winning and make its way here to you.
I'll not deny it.
Are you saying that you desire Dane's defeat?
No, I am not. If you think through it clearly, Dane will not lose. We had many plans when we started this war. We went through many scenarios and many predictions. But as you know, our predictions have been completely overturned by this gang of rabble. Was it luck? Or was it in the gap? Was it in the gap in skill between the individual soldiers? And if it is, aren't you interested in seeing how far they can come? I do not understand.
Perfect!
Nothing raises my spirits like war. Come, Crimea. Let me be the one to consume your noble hearts.
So yeah, finally brings an end to this chapter. Oh boy, the long battle is over. But we got a longer battle next time. As next chapter, it's the chapter I worry about. But until then, that'll do it for me, Peacemaker 2448, and I will see you on the next episode of Fire Emblem, Path of Radiance.